So it's fight week. I just had my last sparring session at Lauzon MMA. I had to come down from Canada a little early and do some medicals for my fight. But I went into Lauzon MMA, which is one of the gyms that I kind of started at. It's in Easton, Massachusetts, and it's run by the legendary UFC fighter, Joe Lauzon. And every time I'm in town, I usually go there for their team training and their sparring. But I made a little montage, I guess, of my last sparring. I'm actually here at my old apartment in Providence, Rhode Island, where I used to live with my best friend, Mickey Zekili. This is Mickey. She's the best. Also known as Cool Dog. She's a comic book artist and she's a purple belt in jiu-jitsu as well. She's phenomenal. She's such a good person and such a good grappler and a talented artist. But overall, she's just like a really solid person. So, one of my favorite people here in Providence. Yeah, the fight is coming up. I have about 13 to 12 pounds left to lose. Which shouldn't be too hard. It's normally what I do. I normally get to about 10 pounds over the week of the fight, and then I sweat from there. Feeling a little run down, feeling a little tired, but it's nothing that I'm not used to. So I think I'll do another vlog, kind of like getting closer to the fight and taking you guys around Providence, kind of that's some of my favorite spots. But I just wanted to do like a quick one. Kind of show you my last sparring and yeah, all I have to do is make weight and then fight and everything is good. And then hang out for a couple days, go back to Canada, eat some pizza, and life is great again.
That they're not really gone. Time has proven that fooling yourself into believing the lie is the most effective way to deal with things you have no control over. Keep listening to the mixtapes they made you. Overanalyze every single word you hear. Was this a sign that things were going wrong? No, no. You were the one who cared too hard, not them. Stay up every single night staring at your phone, either attempting to gather up the courage to turn these demons, these constant reminders of your loneliness into nothing more than a bad dream, or praying just for one second you could feel the warmth of equally returned love. Go out for coffee 4 times a week by yourself. Always bring your notebook, never stop writing. Leave little comics and thank you notes with your tip. Watch them smile as you get in your car. Talk down on yourself whenever possible. My life is shit because I deserve it, right? You must have done something really bad. It's nearly impossible for you to cry now. Avoid your friends for weeks, even though they're the only sense of consistency you have left in your life. If they really wanted to see you, they'd come, but they won't. Who cares? Allow yourself to lose interest in the things you love. Watch as you begin to take a backseat to the world around you. Don't fight it. Become a secondary character in your own motion picture. But most importantly, drown every single one of your feelings in old stolen rum. Learn to love the taste of it dripping down your throat. Find comfort in the warmth coming from your stomach. You're drinking bottled love now. You don't need other people to drive away your loneliness. You just need to find a way to talk to it.